Hello everyone and welcome back to another episode of our Ark Survival Evolve Let's Play. And in this episode, I want to for sure do one thing and then possibly another, but I want to dedicate an episode pretty much just to getting a bunch of surface loot. I know I got a little bit 2 episodes ago, I think it was, but for a couple reasons, or for one main reason, is because I want to tame a Reaper King. And you kind of need, I mean, you don't need upgraded gear, but it's very helpful to have, because the Reaper Queen will chew through primitive pretty darn fast. And we have some in here, like from Genesis and stuff. And I could do missions, but meh. I mean, you can get it on the surface from, I think it's yellow and red drops. And yeah, I know I didn't see any yellow and red, it was just blue and purple, but I'm gonna, since I'm actually gonna like be looking for these, I'll go to the different surface areas, see which place I have the most luck with, and check it out. But yeah, I don't know, I just kind of want to do that. The other thing is maybe build a greenhouse on here, because I want plant species Z seeds, because they're just like little flashbangs, but that's whatever. I also did name the Featherlight and the Shinehorn, so thank you Krill99 for blueberry, and thank you PrettyPH for the Shinehorn name, Luna. And I think they both work pretty well. But, oh yeah, and also I did, in the meantime, go over to the other maps and grab some of the all the upgraded shields I could find, bar one. Because we had one on the island that was like a journeyman wooden shield and I just didn't even bother. But these were all the good ones I could find, so yeah, I think those will be definitely very helpful with taming a Reaper King. And I actually need to see, because like, okay, since it's daytime right now, I have to wait till it's nighttime to go to the surface anyways. Oh yeah, and then also in the meantime, I repaired the desert cloth wall and scorched it. But I'm getting sidetracked. I'm going to work on getting materials for greenhouse stuff. Oh yeah, I only have the walls learned. Okay, I'm gonna need to learn all the other stuff too, but it shouldn't be that bad. Alright, well I hope I mined up enough crystal, so, cause I need the ceiling still. Yep, okay. Perfect, now should have pretty much everything. I will need to take some stone with me though, because I'm gonna need to craft at least one pipe. I just didn't craft the pipes right now because I didn't know exactly how many I would need, if any. So I mean, I'm probably at least gonna need one, because I'm gonna put it down by where the dinos are at the river. So when it's done, I'll take it down there. There we go. Oh, that's the wrong thing, that's cementing paste. Okay, so I think, because like, it's still daytime. Yeah. Okay, I do think I'm going to go to the surface even on the 50-50 times. The only time I'm going to avoid the surface is on the 90-day 10-night. So, should be fine right now, and I just realized I didn't craft any stairs. Honestly, I kind of want to put it where all these rocks are. So I'm going to break these. I know I can get metal from them if I use a pickaxe, because they're the river rocks, or not the one I'm breaking, but like, oh, I'm gonna need to drop a bunch. Whatever. I still will get a bit, but whatever. I'm just gonna clear these out right now. Okay. That should be good, and now I'm just gonna sink it kinda. You know, let's place the back one, because maybe I won't need to use stairs if I am smart about this. And place it kind of like that. And I also probably, if I was smart about placing it close enough to the water, I shouldn't really have to make any more pipes, which will be nice. I mean, it doesn't really matter, because they're cheap. Oh, I'm so dumb. Alright, well, I have to go make another one of those. Okay, let's try this again. And yeah, I don't need stairs because of because it's close enough to the... That's not the right thing. It's close enough to the ground out here that you can just kind of step up it. Well, I mean, it does stop you briefly, even though it's low, so I might still make stairs just to make the transition smoother. But that's not super important. Now, oh, well, actually, I'm going to place this stuff first, because for the plant species Z things, you have to have a large crop plot, which is kind of annoying, but also whatever. The annoying thing, though, is with the size of greenhouse I'm building, probably should have made a bigger one, but that's, yeah. So I'm going to put the large one right here. I am going to make sure these are all lined up, relatively at least. Oh, you know what I should do, though? I should place the water first, and actually, okay, I can place it, like, in here, so that works. Because I'm going to place the water first, because if I don't place it first, oops, then it'll place the pipe on top of the crop plot. I don't want that, because it'll look ugly. And now there's an earthquake, so I'm going to have to wait, because it's impossible lining stuff up when the ground's shaking under you. Alright, well, they're all placed, and we're actually now going to have to go tame a dung beetle. Let's see, irrigated, that's not done. Irrigated, and that is irrigated. Okay. Oh, wait, is the greenhouse full effect too? Yes, it is. Perfect. So, yeah. I'm going to need to tame a dung beetle, which is whatever, but at least we have a greenhouse now. Functional. So, yeah. But now it actually turned night, so I'm going to head up to the surface, and actually, I think... because I was going to say, I want to go to the one that's close to us again, but I might actually head down there, because I did check, because I know the hazard gear spawns in, I know it for sure spawns on the red ones, or the red drops, I think yellow too, but I looked at the, at the, like, map on the wiki for where all the loot drop spawns are. And it says there's more, or it looks like there's more in the bottom one. So, I think, well, actually, okay, I might wait for a 90 night to go down there. Right now, since it's just shorter, and I want to get there as fast as possible because it just turned night, I'm just going to go to this one. But I'm for sure going to have to spend multiple nights in-game doing this. So that's whatever, it's fine. I'm fine wearing the desert cloth, I guess, because I repaired it, and it is bright. Okay. We should be fine? Yeah. Okay. So, now to basically just wait for loot, and then I guess next daytime we can go down the bioluminescent zone. Oh, red, perfect. That's perfect. But next, like, daytime... go down the bioluminescent zone and tame up a dung beetle, because gonna have to do that. Alright, well, sat here for a little bit and it's not poked its head out. It'd be just my luck that it will when I hop off, but oh, shotgun. It's not amazing, but it's pretty good, actually. Oh no, it's not as good as the one I'm currently using, but it's still decent. I'll definitely take that. Alright, well, it's almost daytime, and there was just that one red drop and three blue drops. I mean, the stuff we got out of them was decent, I guess. I'm just gonna get back down, because it's kind of almost morning, so I don't want to spend too much time up there, but, let's see, two roll rat saddles, a shotgun, and then these, which, yeah. so it's alright, I guess. Actually, how expensive is that? That's never gonna craft that when I have this one. Because, meh, I mean, I don't know if I'm gonna tame a roll rat. Maybe, I don't know. At this point, I honestly don't know if I'll tame one. But, okay, it's gonna be morning pretty soon, so I guess I'll put all this away, gather up some poop, and then see if I can't go and find a high-level dung beetle or something. Ooh! 135, and it's like kind of Christmas colored. Don't you attack my dung beetle. What's that one? 85. That's not bad either. But you know, I won't turn down a 135 dung beetle. I just have to get rid of all this stuff that'll try and attack me when I hop pop. Come on. I saw a snake of earth over here. There we go. Alright. Nothing else? Like no ravagers or anything? I don't see any. Okay. It's this one, right? Yes. Okay. Oh, I don't have a crow pod on me. And I have a shoulder pet on. One is gonna have to kind of just stay down here for a second and hopefully not die. That's gonna be interesting. Okay, there we go. I'm gonna name it Gloop. And that's because it's a mix of glow and poop. Gloop. Let's see. So, should be fine down here. Oh, wait. Oh, no, that's an Iguanodon. Yeah, it should be fine for a little bit. I just have to run back up to base and grab a Cryopod. So, hang tight, Gloop, and don't die, please. If it dies, I'm gonna be annoyed. But it's not super important. I mean, you don't have to have a high-level dung beetle. It literally just affects its weight. That's really about it. And I just stumbled across that one because I was like, eh. I want something higher than level 20, because that was what the other one I saw was before it. Ooh, red one, though, right up here. What level are you? 95, that's not bad, either. Just don't know how I'd tame it, because it's, like, quite literally just on the side of a cliff face. Alright, Gloop is safe. And the good thing, too, is, oops. That canceled it. The good thing too is the greenhouse is within range of the trough, so any spoiled meat that generates in the trough, I can just kind of immediately, Gloop can just kind of eat out of there, because I don't know. I mean, I won't have to keep stock of spoiled meat in its inventory like I do on all the other dung beetles, because the greenhouse is too far away from the trough on like literally every other map. So that's it's a convenience at least. And now I just basically have to wait for more poop. And then we can get fertilizer. I guess I could also get seeds while I'm waiting for it to turn night again. Finally, a Savaroot seed. Oh my gosh, that took absolutely forever to get. I had to wait for these to respawn. Oh, it didn't take that long. I cleared everything out down here, then ran up to the house to transfer all the narco berries and acerbic mushrooms, I think they're called, and then I came back and they're all respawned. But I was getting so many all the other seeds and I just could not get a Savaroot seed, but alas, we did get one. So now I have all of them to put in there, and if anybody has poop to kindly donate to me, I will appreciate it so that the dung beetle can get to work. Oh, and I still should make stairs. I put a Z seed in there. Let's put that in there. What's another tall one? Citronelle's tall. That in there. And that in there. Okay. Well, now whenever we get poop, I can start producing fertilizer. Or not me, but oh, I see poop. Give me your poop. There we go. I can start getting the dung beetle to produce some fertilizer, so I guess there's some start. You know what? I know I see that one over there still, but that's live life dangerously. So, whoop. Spino saddle. And another hatchet blueprint. I think that's better than the one we got last episode. That's really good. That spino saddle is also pretty good. I might craft that. Actually, how expensive is it? Just take care of the seeker first. on. Oh, it's on my butt and I can't smack it. Okay. Anger of the Nameless. Okay. So, I mean, it's expensive, but it's actually not unreasonable. So I might just have to craft that. Alright, well, I actually decided to come over to this, like, southern surface. The one in the southwest of the map. Because I figured we might have better chances. I'm being dumb. Now, this one might very well get lost out here. Because I do not know this one nearly as well. I mean, like, obviously I can go around, but, like, okay, that's what the entrance looks like. Okay, now I'm hoping this one will have at least, like, more than one drop coming down at once, because the other one only had one, like, ever coming down at once. I see that blue one right there. So, oh yeah, good, there is two. Okay. I'm gonna go for that purple one, I think, just because it has higher loot and higher loot quality in it. But yay, that's a good sign. There's at least like two coming down at once. Oh wait, no, there's three because there's another purple one right here. That's really good. All right, this might be where I come, even though it's like the farthest one away. 30. Didn't hear a Reaper though, so. There's a Seeker, but that's eh. Oh yeah, look at that. Already a red drop coming down back there. This one is probably, yeah, the most efficient. It's like, I could have sworn from the past that the only one that only ever had, like, one drop coming down was a super small one, but guess I was wrong. This one isn't even that much larger. In fact, it looks smaller, to be honest. But, I won't complain still. Alright, just landed, and probably gonna be a Reaper? No, really. Okay then. Well. That's, wait. That's actually a pretty darn good blueprint. And it's good it's a blueprint, because I can crafting skill that. That'll be really nice to have for Rockwell. And it's actually not, like, outrageously expensive either, which is really good. So, yeah, that's good shotgun blueprint. Wait. There's two drops coming down on top of one another here. Yeah, yeah. Ooh, Christmas one. But, how is that a thing? There's two purple drops on top of one another. I'm so confused. Would you just go away? Don't push me off the edge though, please. Just want you out of here. You look neat. If I could tame one that looks like you, I'd be happy, but I don't think that'll happen. You push me. Oh, no. No, no, get me out. Okay. Alright, well, how is two of these gonna work? Is that okay? It's just like that. Alright, well, I got another glider suit. That's good. Ooh, double yellow. I only saw that purple one way back there and I was disappointed, but nope. Turned around and there's two yellows dropping down. This spot on the surface is the best one, at least from this one. This episode and the last one, or the last one we went to. So far I've already had more red drops and now the two yellows in here than I did the other one, so yeah, I think it's pretty safe to say this one's the best. Oh, this might be interesting. Two at once. Oof. I just want this yellow drop. At least neither of you hit super hard. I mean, it hit hard because of Reaper case, but, like, there have definitely been ones that have hit way harder. And they're doing the thing where they go around the side so that I can't hit them. Alright, one's dead. Perfect. And of course, Seeker. I thought that was a Reaper King that killed for a second. I was happy, but whatever. I guess maybe I should come down here before they're done landing, just see if there's any Reapers. That's probably best, rather than waiting for them to land and then come down here. Might be what I start doing. And also, is it just me or is it weird that Reaper Kings don't drop Chitin? I don't know, it just seems like they would. At least to me. Alright, there we go. Don't walk through the acid burn cloud. And let's get this drop. Shouldn't be anymore, so. Compound bow is actually not half bad. And you get your stamina. I might have to force. I can force feed you during the day, actually. Oh, it's 90 day, 10 night. I didn't realize that. Alright, I'm gonna get this drop, and I might have to head out. Because not gonna be night for very much longer down here. And if I've noticed one thing, unfortunately now I have three. Oh my gosh. Okay. Well. But anyways, if I've noticed one thing, the Reaper Kings also come out of the ground much faster down here. I might have to bail though, because three at once might. Oh wait, where'd the green one go? I actually don't know. But three at once is, and oh wow, they're hitting hard. I don't want to be stuck. Wow, you guys are hitting hard. Okay, I'm gonna. I'm cocooned, so I can't really leave right now. But you cocoon me again. All right. Well, no. Okay. I don't want them to cocoon me, so I can't really get away. There's one dead, and it is getting daytime fast. I have to go. Bye. No. All right, let me get out of here. No, you glide. Okay. That was close, and I don't want to catch on fire. Well, rip yellow drop. It's kind of whatever, but yeah, I had to get out of there. Whoo, boy. Oh yeah, see now daytime music, so I had to leave at that like exact moment. Oh no, wait. Stupid Stegos and their new TLC fancy stuff. You just in my way and that's it. I have 600 health. Yeah, this Rock Drake's like almost dead. That's fun. Alright, well, Rock Drake's all healed up finally, but I guess one thing I can do as well while I'm waiting for it to be nighttime again is go show you one thing that's actually really nice about Aberration. And I want to make sure I have enough weight, but so, if you don't have access to Extinction or, like, gachas or anything like that, Aberration is actually probably the second easiest map to get Black Pearls on. Because, like, Black Pearl gachas are obviously the easiest. The island, it's just, like, killing alphas in the ocean. So, I mean, it's not hard if you have a good underwater creature, but it's not easy either. Aberration, you just go down and pick them up off the ground. So I'll show you where you can do that if you don't already know. Okay, it's actually just like right down here where you'd go down to for the Rock Drake nest area. Just kind of right by this big old skeleton. Just kind of go to the left side of it right down here. And of course, there's always going to be Rock Drakes down here. But those little like shiny things that look like silk pearls but are black, those are black pearls. So that's really nice. Actually, fighting Rock Drakes compared to Surface Reaper Kings is so much better. Oh, I'm so glad we have backup Rock Drakes at least, because if anything bad did happen, yes, I'd have to go recover my stuff. Which actually, I don't know how I'd do that. Just burning up and all that good stuff. But, yeah. And I'm actually gonna get rid of that one. Is there any over there? Well, there's one way up there, but shouldn't be an issue. But anyways, yeah, these, I mean, they give you a bunch too, so if you're in need for black pearls and stuff for, like, tech on here, or just anywhere, and you have aberration but don't have extinction. Actually, even when I had extinction, I'd come here sometimes, because, like, you know, crafting up, like, canvases, flags, or, like, war maps, or whatever you use, just it takes a while. Whereas here, you just grab them off the ground. Like, 46, 51. You have to make sure not to step into that stuff, though, because that will kill you and your shoulder pet. So, I mean, with the hazard suit, you have a couple more seconds, as I found out in the cave when I accidentally took a quick dive into it. But yeah, it's like lava, where you have a couple seconds, but it's not much. And it's actually really nice that they seem to have fixed the rock drake walking thing, because that was always a pain to deal with down here. But yeah, this is basically just where I like to come for black pearls on aberration, because it's just super easy, especially once you have a rock drake. Alright, well, 10 of these actually are ready, and that's the max amount that it will store. Finally, I got a 10-day 90 night, so I'm just waiting for the next night cycle, because it went from the 90-day 10 night to straight to that. But anyways, these are like little flash grenades when the model loads. Yeah, so like you can chuck them way away. That's going to go over the edge, or not. But yeah, it does that. And I guess if sensitive to light, I would look away. But like it's like, okay, well, I guess I wasn't close enough. But alright, they used to flash you. I guess they made it so they don't flash you anymore or something like that. Yeah, it just doesn't. Okay. It should still flash creatures. No. Alright, well, okay. They used to flash you, make your screen go white, kind of like the flashbang effect in CSGO. Yeah, I don't know. It will make things aggro onto you if it affects them. Actually, can I? It didn't even affect the trilobite. It does give you the charged effect from the little dots and whatever, but yeah, I guess they just don't anymore. Actually, wait, there's that Carbonemys, and it's a wild dino, so will it work on that? Wherever it is. Oh, it did. Okay. So it has that effect where it's flashbang and it'll now be angry at me. Yeah. It like stuns it for a little bit. And do that. Oh, no, it didn't work. Alright, well now it's angry at me, so I have to get rid of it. But that's essentially what it does. I guess they've made it so you can't flashbang yourself or your own creatures anymore, which is actually really nice. I just didn't know they fixed that. Plus the, if you have these planted out in the open, because they don't need to be in a greenhouse, it gives you the charged effect. So if you're building a base down in the blue zone, and you have a reliable source of fertilizer and water. Water isn't an issue down there, but if you have a reliable source of fertilizer, just plant some of those around your base. And you shouldn't really have to deal with Nameless. It's better than setting up light pets everywhere, because light pets have they aren't ever charged when you first log in, whereas those will immediately start putting out charged effects. Like, those dots all the way around are actually that thing, so it has a really large area. It's just because it's inside a building, it's only giving out the charged effect in there. But anyways, I'm gonna head back over to that southern surface way over there, because that seemed to work best, as long as I don't have to fight three Reaper Kings at once. If I have to do that, I might just ditch that supply drop. Because for all I know, that one could have had, they had, some of the, whatchamacallit, the hazard gear in it. And also, just in case anything like that happens and I'm not able to get out, I'm not going to bring everything with me that I don't really need. So It's like, I won't need those. I'll bring the shotgun to be safe. Because, like, we have other means of, whatchamacallit. Other shotguns. And, like, now a blueprint. So, I'm gonna head over. Well, actually, I don't need to head over there now. Yeah, because it's only 5 doi. Okay, well, I'm gonna wait, and then I'll head over there when it's starting to get night again. And then we can actually go get more loot. And I'm actually gonna need to cook up some meat, too, so I'm gonna do that really quickly, too. Ooh! That's pretty good. The flak helmet's not too bad either, but that's pretty good. Alright, the weapon damage doesn't matter. But, you know, you're too slow. I hopped off, got the loot drop already, so you're just gonna have to wish that you were faster. but yeah, that's the weapon damage doesn't matter. I wish the durability was a bit higher, but you know, that's still pretty good, because I believe the regular ones have 64 durability, if I'm not mistaken. So, that's much better still. Alright, well, stamina's full. Got just a little bit of meat in. Not much, but any reapers? If there's no reapers, I'll be happy. Oh, there's you, but not that big of a deal. There we go. Well, sickle, and actually that's pretty darn good hazard chest piece. Fortunately, it's not a blueprint, but I will still definitely take that. Anyways, now I need to just go sit up here, wait for either another good drop to land, and force feed in the process, pretty much. Because I don't even think, at least with needing to force feed right now, I don't think I'm gonna even bother with blue drops, maybe even purple. Because, like, there's a blue and a purple, but, yeah. Oh, it came out of the ground right as I jumped off, but, that's pretty good, boots, actually. But, wow, that could have gone badly. That's the first time I've risked it and had one come out of the ground, like, right as I hop off. But whatever, it's 0.5, so it's fine. And we successfully did it, but wow. First drop back out here, and we got some pretty darn good boots. You know, I have the gloves and the helmet already. We got the chest piece, we have boots now. So really the only thing we're actually missing is pants. And is that an alpha, or is that just red Christmas flavor? Because I'm honestly kind of surprised I haven't run into an alpha yet. Where's backwards? Oh, you can get up here. It's just red Christmas flavor, though, because it has green on its stomach. Alright, let's grab this. Paris or platform saddle? And another one that jumps out right as I hop off. Jeez. With that being 2 for 2, I hope that the third one isn't where it actually gets to me when I'm off, but we'll see. Trying to be as safe as possible about it, but I don't know. Oh, look, there's 2 just kind of roaming out in the open up here. And a third one back there. Ah. Why is it always... It's this spot right here exactly where I always encounter 3 Reaper Kings. I don't know why. Because, like, there's that one over there, which is probably going to aggro. So these guys are going to push me towards it. It's interesting. This is the third time it's happened, so I'm pretty sure this is where we were when I had to bail the first time. At least those are both pretty low level. Can I? Well, actually, there's the 2. I guess I could wait for those to, the other one to be fully down. I hope that Reaper King over there doesn't come over here and try to grasp me, though. Oh, actually, it did fully land, so let's just try it. Give me that, and give me that. Okay. It's interesting how that happens, but whatever. So far, it seems like I've kind of lucked out. Fingers crossed that the Reapers haven't been super high level. It's like, they still hit hard. Like, this one I can tell isn't very high level, because it's, yeah, it's not hitting absurdly hard. Anyway, Let's grab this. Ooh, Rock Drake Saddle. Oh, that's so good. I'm gonna use that right now, actually, because that will help tanking. Oh, I just flew through the cloud. But that'll help tanking the Reaper Kings a lot. Make it a lot easier. Oh, you're that, like, Christmassy one. I see. Wait, you only... Okay, I was gonna say, it's only biting me for 72. For, like, compared to other Reapers, that's, like, peanuts. And it was level 25. I've had level 5 Reapers hit harder than that, and I still walk through the acid bird. Okay. That's kind of funny. Ways. Ooh, that's a good long neck. I don't know if that's better than the current long neck I'm using, but that is a pretty darn good long neck. If I do say so myself. And I've kind of just gotten to the point where I'm just... And I mean, if there's a little while where, like, another drop doesn't come down, then I will go and grab the blue and purple ones. But, like, other than that, if there's a consistent flow of, like, yellows, like there kind of has been, not really, sort of, whatever, I'd just leave them. But I might grab them. We'll see. Alright, well, anyways, I'm gonna say that was pretty darn successful, at least. I don't know how long it'll be, so if it's super long, I'm sorry. I'm gonna try and edit it down as much as possible. But anyways, I hope you enjoyed, and I'll see you in the next one.